clear, follow 8, and we have a picture that's good.
Roger, we're getting a lot of static. The Sea of Crises is in front of us on the horizon, and the dark crater Picard can be seen in the middle. We're now breaching the moon's sunrise, or the spacecraft sunset. This is an area that the sun has just recently come up on the moon. Approaching lunar sunrise, and for all the people was light, and God saw the light, that it was good, and God divided the light from the darkness.
And God called the light day, and the darkness he called night, and the evening and the morning were the first day. And God said, let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters. And God made the firmament, and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament. And it was so. And God called the firmament heaven, and the evening and the morning were the second day.
For this from their home, as we saw for the first time a lunar sunset as they reached in toward the dark part of the moon over an area called the Earth glow on the moon, which is almost as dark as the dark side itself. But that is the sunset of the moon. And we heard first Bill Anders, and then Jim Lovell, and finally Frank Borman reading from the book of Genesis, the Bible, and that final word, good luck and God bless Earth. Now they are continuing now around the moon, continuing across the face of the moon, but the dark part of the face of the moon as we view it tonight in that crescent-shaped moon we see from Earth. They will go around now one more time, and then at shortly after 1 o'clock this morning, fire the engines that will return them to Earth. And we will be reporting that, of course. Coretta King and Mrs. Robert Kennedy, 60 Minutes, which is normally scheduled to be on now, will follow this broadcast. And during that 60 minutes, Harry Reasoner and Mike Wallace will be spending Christmas Eve with those two gallant ladies, Coretta King and Mrs. Robert Kennedy. CBS News color coverage, the flight of Apollo 8, will continue in a moment. So, another remarkable look at the moon. Pictures taken by man as he flew over that surface in the spacecraft which has been the first to reach the moon from Earth. Apollo 8, now in its next to last orbit of the moon, the crew admitting fatigue after their historic adventure, resting up for the most critical maneuver of their flight, the one that starts them back to Earth. At about 1:06 a.m. tomorrow, that's just 2 hours from now, in the early hours of Christmas morning, while Apollo 8 is behind the moon, out of touch with the ground control again, the astronauts are to start up that big rocket engine that powered them into lunar orbit. It must work perfectly again, because if it fails to start or doesn't work long enough, Apollo 8 could be caught in that lunar orbit. That, of course, is not expected to happen. The engine has worked perfectly. In a total of 6 firings so far, it should work on the 7th. Our next progress report will be at 1 a.m. Eastern Time, when we'll wait and watch with you to see that everything does work perfectly and Apollo 8 is indeed on the way home after its historic 10 orbits of the moon. This is Walter Cronkite at the CBS News Space Center in New York.
This has been a CBS News special report, the flight of Apollo 8.